It's really difficult to create a proper text stroke effect on web today. The problem is we don't have a standard text stroke property in CSS. We only have WebKit text stroke, which is a non-standard property, and there are certain problems with it. In this video, I will show you how it works, I will show those problems, and how to go around them using the background clip property. And essentially, this will allow us to create gradient text strokes. Let's jump right in. Okay, I have created a simple demo on CodePen to demonstrate this. You're gonna find the link in the description if you wanna play with the finished version of the code. Setup is quite simple. We have a headline here with a class of headline and a little bit of CSS. I have added a subtle background to our page here, and I'm using Google Fonts Railway and Montserrat for the demonstration purposes. On CodePen, you can add Google Fonts if you go into settings, HTML, stuff or head. You can add a link here and use it in your code. And this is pretty much it for the setup. Now, what we want to do here is we want to actually create a stroke for this headline. And we can do this if we use WebKit text stroke property. Unfortunately, this is not a standard property and it's not on standard track, which means that support for this could change at any moment, but all browsers are supporting this property and all browsers, as far as I have tested, work consistently. So we actually can use this as there's not really a good alternative for text stroke, as you'll see in this tutorial. So let's try adding this. And we're just gonna add a modifier here. And let's add this to our CSS. And this is only available with the WebKit prefix. And this is actually a shorthand for two properties, WebKit text stroke color and WebKit text stroke width. But we will not use a shorthand property here. So color. And we're gonna add red, for example, and WebKit text stroke width, let's do 2 pixels. And this already works. So what we really wanna do is we wanna have a white color of the text and just this bluish outline. So let's do this. Let's set color to one of the whites we actually used on our background. This one, for example. And let's change our stroke color to this blue. And here is our effect. And this already works, but the problem here is that, as we've mentioned, WebKit text stroke is not a standard property and it could be removed from browsers at any point. So if this were to happen, we would end up with something like this. And this is a major accessibility problem because this text is unreadable, but we can actually get around this if we use another property related to our text stroke. And this is going to be WebKit text fill color. And this is essentially gonna set the fill of our color to, well, whatever we set here. And now if a browser stops supporting text stroke, we're gonna end up with a version that looks like this. And this is going to be perfectly accessible, even though it's not gonna be as good looking as in our example. One thing to note when you're using text stroke is that not all fonts work the same way. So for example, if we try Montserrat here, you're gonna see that stroke contains quite a lot of those weird artifacts here. So you actually want to make sure that the font you're using is built well and that you don't have a problem like this. Let's return to Railway. So as this is not a standard property, a lot of people actually go a different route and use an alternative method to create a text stroke. And this is usually done by using text shadow. And we're going to show this next. Let's create another element here. So we're going to do headline text shadow. And we're going to create a text shadow. Text shadow takes a couple of values. X offset, Y offset, blur radius, and text color. And let's add purple we already have, this one. And as in previous example, we're gonna set our color to be white. And in this case, we can actually use color because text shadow is a standard property, so we don't have to fear that browsers will stop supporting it at certain point in time. And this effect is quite a bit different. And the difference is that we cannot specify blur spread on our text shadow here. The way around this and to actually emulate the text stroke is to create a number of text shadows and position them all around the edges of the text. So we can do this if we specify minimum blur radius of 1 pixel and then just copy our entire text shadow and position it in all directions. First 1 pixel, 1 pixel. Then let's do -1, -1. Then let's do 1, -1, and -1, 1. And essentially we have created 4 text shadows and positioned them ever so slightly in all directions of the element. So this appears like a stroke. And this is just 1 pixel stroke, but if we wanted to create a 2 pixel stroke, we will actually have to copy all of this and position it 2 pixels away. So this would become 2 pixels, 2 pixels, 2 pixels, and 2 pixels. If you look closely, you're gonna see that this is not really ideal, and you're gonna see that the edges here are pretty rough. Now, this might not be a major problem, but it's not ideal. And the difference between those two versions is essentially that text shadow is applied outside of the letter shapes, and the text stroke is applied to the middle of the edge of our letters, which means that half of our 3 pixel spread is going to be on the outside and half on the inside. And that's why this version appears a lot smaller than this one. The downside of using text shadow is that you have to create quite a lot of really messy code if you want to have more than 1 pixel stroke. Another downside here is that those edges here are not really perfect, and it's probably going to be even more prominent if you use a bigger font size. But the upside is that you can actually use it with fonts that are not built in a way that works with the text stroke. We can see this in our Montserrat example here. So text shadow works as expected, while our text stroke is exhibiting these weird artifacts. Let's return to Railway here. And we actually can go around this if we use background clip property. And I'm going to show you how right now. So let's just create another version of our headline and add a modifier background clip. All right, and we're gonna copy this code here. And what we wanna do here is we wanna create a background. Let's do red, for example. And we are going to use background clip property to apply this, well, red in this example, background, only to the shape of our letters. Background clip lets us define how to render background of the element. We can render it on the border of the element, on padding, on content, or just on the text. And that's what we're gonna do in this example. And now this background is applied only to the shape of our letters. And we don't see anything here because, well, background is behind our stroke and behind our fill color. So here we're gonna set transparent stroke color. This is going to allow our red background to come through. And now as our fill color is set to this white, our stroke is coming through only outside of the shape of letters, which is essentially what we have in our example with the text shadow here. So if we want the 3 pixel stroke, we actually have to use a value of 6, because half of this is going to be applied on the outside, which is visible, and half is going to be applied on the inside, which is, well, covered with the fill color of white. And let's use our blue color for this example as well. And this actually allows us to go around our problem with the different fonts, as we've seen in this example with Montserrat. Like, this version works perfectly fine, while this version is exhibiting those strange artifacts. Let's go back to Railway. So essentially, this version with the background clip allows us to go around this problem of having our stroke in the middle of the edge, which is especially gonna be visible if you increase the stroke width. If you were to use 6 pixels here, this will soon become unreasonably problematic, while this example is going to be perfectly fine. And another beautiful thing about using background clip is that you can actually specify even linear gradients instead of a background color. So let's do this next. Another example is going to be background clip. And let's add another modifier, linear gradient. Let's create a selector, background image, linear gradient. We're gonna set it to the 120 degrees angle. And we're gonna go from this blue we're using for our stroke or ending color. Let's use red. Let's see how this works. And I have used the wrong color. I actually wanted this color from here. And there we go. We have actually created a linear gradient as our stroke. And this looks pretty, pretty great. And we can also play around with it even more and maybe create another example. Maybe let's create a radial gradient. And for the radial gradient, let's just copy this entire selector here. Radial gradient. And we don't need angle. And here it is. It's a beautiful radial background for our headline. A beautiful thing about this is that if for some reason a browser stops supporting, well, one of those properties, we're not gonna see any kind of problems because we're just gonna see our solid color as a fallback from here. And if the browser supports text stroke, non-standard text stroke property, we're gonna see this beautiful version that we have created right here. In this video, I have shown you how text stroke property works. I have shown you an alternative method to create text stroke using the text shadow property. And lastly, I've shown you how to apply background clip to create this beautiful gradient text stroke. So I hope you found this helpful or at least interesting. Make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss my future videos. My name is Zoran Nyambor. Thank you so much for your attention. I will see and hear you in the next video.